Welcome again after a short break. So we were doing different type of the functions. So in this series, now I am going to tell you about the count function. So as I discussed in my earlier video, the count function, why it was used. So the count function, it was used to count the number of numeric data in a particular range. For example, here we are using a particular range, that is from A1 to A5, and we want to calculate total numerical numbers in this particular series. So this is our selected range. So in that situation, we want to count the numeric number, that means numeric data we want to calculate here. So here 10 5, after that a is not numeric data, after that 9 10 is there. So accordingly, the total answer, total number of the numerical data will be equal to 4, because here A is not a numeric data, so we have the answer, that is 4. So this function will give us the number of the numerical data in a particular range which we have selected. So when we will perform this function, after performing this function, when you will click, when you will enter, then the answer will come out as 4. So here 4, what is this? This is the total number of the numeric data in the range, that is A1 to A5. So next function is count A function. So count A function, why it is used? अभी जो हमने function use किया है, ये किस लिए हमने use किया? हमने इसलिए use किया because we want to know only the numeric data in a particular range. But if we want to know total number of data, whether it is text, whether it is numeric, so in that situation we will use the function count A. That means अगर हम ये formula use करेंगे तो उस situation के अंदर जो result आएगा, तो वो result किस तरह से आएगा? Excel will calculate all this as irrespective of whether it is text or numeric. क्योंकि पहले वाला जो हमने function किया था उसके अंदर जो result आया था, that was related to only numeric data. But in count A function, what it will do? It will do the calculation by taking into consideration both text and numerical values. So here count A function, how it is performed, we can see. So there is a range. Which range it is? This range is A1 to A5. So we are performing here count A function. Count A function, that means it will count the total cells. Total cells, irrespective of this, whether these are text or numeric value. So in that situation, there are total 5 cells. So the answer will come out as 5. So whether it is text, whether it is numeric, so it will calculate all these values. So next function is count blank function. Count blank function, it is a type of the functions which is used to count the blank cell in a particular range. अगर हमारे पास कोई ऐसा data है जिसके अंदर कुछ हमारे पास blank cells भी हैं, we don't have data for that particular cell. तो इस situation के अंदर इन blank cells को हम कैसे count करेंगे? If we want to know the blank cell in a particular range, तो situation में हम क्या use करते हैं? Count blank. For example, हमने एक particular range select किया है A1 to A5. So in that situation, there are 3 type of the data. One is text data, and after that 2 are numeric data. So here total rows are 5, but here are some blanks also. So accordingly, 2 cells are blank and 3 are there which are numeric as well as text. So when we will be applying this count blank formula, so A1 से लेके A5 तक अगर कोई भी blank आपके पास cell है, so result will come out by using this function. So in this function, what will be the result? Answer will be 2. That means there are 2 cells which are blank, that is 2 and 4, if we are talking about this area. In this area, only 2 cells are blank, So accordingly, the result will come out as 2. So next formula is the average formula. If we want to calculate the average of any range, so we can use this formula, is equal to average, after that argument in brackets. So we want to calculate the average of this cell from A1 to A5. So we will be using this formula. After using this formula, the result will come out as 4. So the 4 represent the average of the cells that starts from A1 to A5. Similarly, अगर हमारे पास कोई ऐसी रेंज है, हम ये देखना चाहते हैं कि उसमें मिनिमम वैल्यू कौन सी है. इन दैट सिचुएशन वी विल बी यूजिंग मिनिमम फंक्शन. सो हियर वी वांट टू नो द मिनिमम वैल्यू इन दिस रेंज फ्रॉम A1 टू A5. वी वांट टू नो द मिनिमम वैल्यू. सो वी विल राइट एज इक्वल टू आफ्टर दैट फंक्शन एंड स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम A1 टू A5. सो अकॉर्डिंगली आर आंसर विल बी 2. Because it gives us the minimum value of that particular range. So the minimum value is 2. After that, max function, which gives us the maximum value in a particular range. Similarly, if we want to calculate the maximum value in this range from A1 to A5, we want to know the maximum value, we will apply this formula, equal to, after that max, and after that argument, that means A1 to A5, we want to know the maximum value. So in that situation, we will apply this formula, and after pressing enter, the result will come out as 9. That means 9 is the highest value in the selected range. So it gives us the maximum value. So we can say the maximum function will return the largest maximum value in the selected range of cells, and the minimum function will display the smallest value in a selected cell of range. So here 75 displays the maximum value, 25 displays the minimum value, and the values are 3 values out of these values we have selected. So in a nutshell, I just want to tell at the end, we have done different type of the functions. We have performed sum, we have performed average, we have performed minimum, we have performed maximum function, count blank function, count A function, and count function. So accordingly, these are the basic formulas which we are using. So here each and every formula is given. Average formula, after that sum formula, minimum, maximum, count blank, count, and count A. All formulas are shown here. So I would like to conclude by again differentiating between formula and function. So formula, as I told you, that the formulas are user defined. These are the mathematical equations which are user defined, which are defined by us. But as far as functions are concerned, so these are predefined. So we can say that the functions, these are inbuilt formulas in Excel. So accordingly, these all are mathematical equation. If we want to perform different type of the calculations, so accordingly we can use different formulas and functions. So at the end, I would like to say thanks to all of you for your patience hearing. So I would like to end my presentation by the beautiful quote by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. If you have to shine like a sun, first burn like a sun. So thank you. Thanks a lot to all of you, and all the best.